back. This is Boomer Life on Sea Isle 650.
Welcome back to Boomer Life here on Sea Isle 650. We're happy together. Those are the turtles for your Saturday morning here. We're talking retirement living with the folks from Shannon Oaks. Jillian Fullerton is team member and a marketing person out there at Shannon Oaks in Vancouver and with Baptist Housing British Columbia. And also with us in studio, just a joy to have Olive Farah back with us.
Thank you.
A longtime resident of Shannon Oaks. And just before the break, Olive, you made an interesting remark, and I'd love to follow up on it. You talked about Shannon Oaks, and you clearly are just one of the happiest humans on the planet because you've been there long enough and you found your niche. It works for you big time.
Absolutely.
But you described Shannon Oaks as being a faith-based community. Now, it is operated by a company called Baptist Housing, which operates communities not only across British Columbia, but right across Canada. Jillian, do you have to be a Baptist to go to Shannon Oaks?
You don't even have to be Christian. We have a Muslim residents. We have non-believers. We have people that are, I would describe as atheists. But, I mean, there's all sorts. But I would say it's about a 50% Christians in there. And we do have Bible studies. We do have chapel service on Wednesday.
And I met the chaplain. What a nice woman.
She's lovely.
Wow, Kara. She's terrific. Yeah.
Karen Anderson, she's a joy. Mm-hmm. She is there to listen to you anytime you want. So if you're going through something that's maybe challenging in your life, some other loss, an anniversary of a loss, just saddle up to Karen and she will just pour you a cup of tea and and just sit there and talk with
you. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if she's pretty busy these days. After the holidays and all the kerfuffle and all the buzz, and busy, all of a sudden life settles right back down. Mm-hmm. And if you've gone through the holidays without a whole lot of buzz and bustle and busy, and, you know, it's just, it's life's pretty quiet. I would imagine, you know, there would be more than a few people being looking for a little stroking of the old soul.
That's
you know?
True. And I think of those people that don't live in a retirement residence and don't have access to people like Karen Anderson. Those people living alone in their apartments, living alone in their homes, that just hear the emptiness, hear the stillness around them, and maybe don't have the ability to get out and be there. If they were in Shannon Oaks, they would have opportunity there for to meet people, to do things, to fill their life with lots of joyful moments, as Olive will tell you.
Right.
I mean, there's just so many choices there that you can do.
And I think, Olive, back me up on this one. I think one of the reasons some people are reluctant to make the big move to Shannon Oaks, to get rid of the condo or the house in the burbs or whatever, is because they're afraid. They're afraid of the finances involved. You know, you're talking, as you mentioned moments ago, market's been pretty healthy here in Vancouver for a long time. You're talking easily six, sometimes seven figures for a home.
That's right.
Of a sudden there's all that dough. And am I going to get ripped off by some Sharpie? All I want to do is sell. This is my game plan. Hang on to the house, cash in my chips, and move into a retirement community. It's all very doable at Shannon Oaks
because
it's so darn affordable, Jillian.
It's affordable, and also you know what you're going to be billed month to month.
Right.
Unlike a lot of places, I may add.
Well, no. Olive made the point here just a few minutes ago. We were talking about, you know, when you first came some years ago, you sold the condo and moved to a retirement community. But before you sold the condo and moved, you hadn't thought for 5 seconds about retirement living.
I didn't know
You didn't have a clue what was out there.
I didn't know it existed.
It was just a great big black hole lacking in information. So a lot of people are still new to the game, Jillian.
Yes. Yeah.
And a lot of them, especially us boomers, just trying to do the right thing by mom and dad and doing our homework here and doing the math.
Yeah.
And, you know, the math isn't all of these communities are not equal. Sometimes the math is pretty weird in some of them because you pay whatever they ask by month and you don't get a month's worth of stuff.
That's right. And what you should do when you're looking at them is a comparison sheet.
Right.
So you take your sheet of what you are paying for now, whether it's your mortgage, your maintenance fee, your cleaning of the garden or whatever, and you put all those costs down, and then you figure out what Shannon Oaks covers.
Right.
And all your meals are covered, every meal, so you've got no shopping to
do. Underline all meals.
All meals.
Right, because
in
some communities that's not the case. You'll get a percentage of your meals per month. Or
you'll get an allowance.
Allowance of some kind.
And and your allowance stays the same, but the costs in the restaurant go up, so you're...
So there are just none of those issues.
No, you get your meals, you pay one set fee.
Right.
There is two extra things over if you're quoted a price, there's two extra things. It's your phone, which is $29 a month, and in Olive's case, because she drives, it's parking, and it's $25 a month.
Okay.
But what else is free is all our bus trips are free. We take you shopping, all of that. When you get your housekeeping done once a week, you get a person coming in cleaning and vacuuming and making your apartment tidy.
That's wonderful.
And all those bus trips that you so much enjoy. You like getting out to the casino and out to the mall. Every now
absolutely.
And. But you know, in some retirement communities, if you want to go for a bus ride to one of those places, you're going to pony up some dough for it.
That's right.
And no freebies.
Yeah.
And at Shannon Oaks, the bus is part of the package.
The bus is part of the package.
Interesting.
Definitely.
And all retirement communities, friends, are not created equal. If there's one takeaway message from today's program here on Boomer Life, this is important stuff, especially for us boomers, because, Jillian, we're still learning.
That's right.
And all retirement communities are definitely not created equal.
They are not. You're correct. So take that comparison sheet. So have those questions and compare each one as to what it is. So you know what your bottom line is.
Almost out of time. Want to very quickly remind folks about this is a few weeks away now. On Wednesday, January 28th at 11:30 in the morning, just before lunch, which will be provided, there is one of those downsizing seminars. And listen, boomers, if you have a senior in your life that's contemplating, to one extent or another, life in a retirement community, make it a point to try and take in one of these downsizing sessions. These are pros who go through this week after week, every year, and they really can handle, Jillian, a lot of the trauma involved with my stuff. I couldn't possibly let go of my stuff. Well, guess what? You can, right, all of you?
It's only stuff, and you can't take it to the cemetery with you.
On that cheery note, Olive, a delight to see you again. Thanks so much for taking time and coming by to visit. It's just wonderful to have you.
Thank you very much.
Jillian.
Happy New Year.
That's right. Happy New Year to you. And we'll see you next time right here on Boomer Life.